Like, seriously. That's so weird. Well, we've got about 12 minutes to go here, and hopefully this will clear up before we start. It's going in and out here, I think. I'm not quite sure. It's like as soon as I hit 8 o'clock, it's like no internet for you. Here you go. I'm stuck on an ad on Twitch. It's going real slow. I can't even see what's happening here. Okay. Minutes to go. Nine minutes to go, and we'll be off. Probably gonna watch Elite and Radicals for the first little bit. See if they end up spiking, and then move on to someone else. I'll check in on Paradigm and Savage because that's our match. Kind of excited for Showdown in quite a long time for me. Valak. No, with Alcatraz. Yeah, about ready to start. 8 minutes, and yeah. Stuck watching the food channel over here on Twitch. Some sort of knockoff McMuffin. 6.5 minutes to go. And I still can't see my screen. Yeah, you gotta test pre-med, you gotta test Call of Power, you have to test the newest mage skill, Heavenly Help, whatever the special skills, PvP skills, Revelation, see if that works, really helps the priest, and then those are most of the draw cards, I guess. Plan B, draw card 2. Yeah. All those skills should affect the Aggroth. So I'm back now, and there's a minute. No, there's not. There's 14 seconds to go. And time to watch.
Time to start here.
No. Oh, looks like Savage didn't show up at all. So we're just going to be facing Paradigm. Like, the whole Savage guild didn't show up. And this is a 3-on-4. Elite. Be spiking. So that's over. Death Angels and Wildcat. Looks like a number one team against number two team. And then we have a nice 4v4 spike here. Is that EOD and no? Kitty Pettings and Shining Force. Kid of Paddings on the left, Shining Force on the right. It's going good, Wyatt. Looks like a lot of the spike teams are using a mage. There's a Swift Raid and Encourage on the Maya, another Encourage. Military Charge, Military Charge. Gemini's not looking too hot. There's a crit, 24, 34 still alive, 9 health. Now time to block that lane with 4 cards. Oh, Refuge, that works. And a Tariel. Interesting block. This looks like it's probably the match to watch right now. Nothing much going on. Looking for another time to spike. There's the Maya and the Myth. Do they have any buffs? Probably not a whole lot left. Only one Ranger and used a Swift Raid already. Mr. Phasnatic. Mr. Fantastic. Phasnastic. Mr. Phasnastic. Blue team just winding down the clock here. Looks like they're going anti, I think, anyways, with an Elven Rebel. There's the dig on the Maya and the Myth. Going another lane, I guess. Trying to hit down every player. And Encourage on, oh, Swift Raid. Don't know why he didn't hit Darius. But that's alright. So 30 damage at least. Okay, 40 with the crits, but Zoa is still very healthy at 30 health. That extra HP boost. Time to clear some stuff. Deadly Blow on the Myth. an interesting play, I guess, blocking the lane there as a refuge is about to run out, leaving Zoa open. But, oh, that's a good card to pack. Killing the Kalista because it's a two count, two attack or less. Two attack, to be exact. And it's always going to line up since it's a 2-8, so that's not a bad skill for spikers to pack.
When they know they're facing some sort of, excuse me,
some sort of power or whatnot. I find it weird that it distracts a card in your hand, that's just odd. Whose healer is that? Ken. Yeah. Not really. You're gonna help too much. So life room on Freyja, life room.
Gemini is blocked off for now.
But Zoa is wide open. Card count is pretty low on the red team. Oh no, 7 cards to the mage, I guess. Hold your wings. Looks like Spike is winning right now. They've almost cleared the field once again. Need to put more than Riley in that lane. Nuke and then fly. Deadly blow on the Maya. Here comes the Myth and the Maya. And he's got one raid left. The Encourage. And Lucius to finish off the Palace Athena there on the top. If you're a mage, you should be packing wings. So why not nuke Riley? That's what I want to know. More refuges are up. Refuge every lane, Zoa down to 2 health. Oh, I guess I missed the re-refuge on Gemini Kitty. Gemini Kitten. So you're gonna have to wait 2 turns. And then have a nuke as well. Clear out Riley, and then have wings to fly with a Myth with Military Charger and Encourage. And the refuge is gone in lane 3. Watch out, Gemini. Riley comes forward. Just need a wings now. With the Myth. Interesting. Packing Poison Swamp in a rush. Not what I would do, but alright. Here comes Artemis giving everything counterattack. Still just need a wings there, take out Gemini Kitten. Here we go. Wings on both, or wings on one. There we go. That sconce Gemini Kittens, it still was. Fly the Maya too. Yes. Don't need more encourages, but they're both gone now. So it's a 4-on-2. Just a matter of these guys running out of cards here. Stormhammer down to 5. Faz at 9. The Mage still has 18 cards, but, you know, not that great. Because you don't have buffs. Stormhammer down to 29 HP, though, so we'll see. Still over 100 HP on the blue team to get through. Oopsies. New computer still getting used to the movements. This touchpad is infuriating. And that's about it. 4 health left on this Kinangia. And 3 lanes wide open right now. Lucas Fenner's gonna finish the job, and that's the match. Well, one more turn, I guess, with Riley Stalin. Nope, block on Riley. And a crit with the Scorch. That works too. Now it's a 4-1, and why are you encouraging that? It's overkill. Military charge, nice. Free Venris from the ice. Doesn't matter about the encourage, it's done. Nice, terrorize Ontario. Terrorize Ontario. Still 15 minutes left till the next round. So there's that. It's, ooh, 8 people. That's more than I thought. Red Loki in the rush. He's very low key. Cheap freeze on Kane. And that's it.
So kitty petties are through there, and there's just a handful of matches left. I know that. No, it's 4 vs 3. I'm gonna just get overrun. It's looking like a long fight.
I'm just gonna look at the other ones. Radicals and EOD. Oh boy. GRX. Going through on Dracros, coming back. Probably another long match as well. I think Radicals will win at the end of that. But I'll just leave this on for now, I think. And not do that. Not jump all over the screen. Maybe I'll go get a mouse. And I found the mouse, so that's good. I think all Facebookers are cash cows. VIP 0 is 1 VIP 3 here.
Can't even put in a USB properly.
There we go. Okay, my mouse, we're good to go here. No mouse pad, but who needs a mouse pad, right? Just use the laptop as a mouse pad. And there goes Yumi taking out that Cletus well just about. Green on the field, and looks like the Radicals are winning right now. 7 minutes left. It goes to HP, and old Dracross is almost dead. It's going to take more damage from Jerax next turn. And Kleista is just deadly. That's the 3 attack. Sending back Odin, interesting, over Jerax. Well, I guess Jerax will just come back and hit you in the face. So that makes sense. Yumi running away from the myth. Champion Knight with Guardian Angel. Got the Vengeful Curse. Aphrodite. And there's the reanimate, well, the Guardian Angel reanimate on the Champion Knight in the bottom square, and Radicals are pushing pretty darn hard. Rage is powering up everything, especially Yumi. Salmonettos, Archangel healing up the field. Jarek's still there. Hasn't really gone anywhere for a while. It's been there 3 turns, and they haven't been able to kill him. If he goes away this turn, then Dracos is dead. Kleista will just have quick mid-speed. Oh, and Vargas is back with a Sacred Touch. I'm Petrified and Augustus, and this match is looking pretty over. Grace gonna take some heavy damage this turn, at least 31. That's without crits. And Jarek's gone back, Dracross is dead. Wallace will probably be dead next turn. And there's 5 minutes left until the next round. Yeah. Yep. Oh, disinfo on Darkus. A little too late. Saxade Farina just stalling the whole board. Just if everyone packed Savior Corella against Spike, it'd be interesting, although I'll probably just get nuked down. You have to sank that thing. Even so, though, just DB. Well, it's dead next turn. So we can do something about it. Probably not. And yep, like I said, this match is over. Radical is just placing creatures now for the fun of it. Yumi at 23 attack. Jays. And Radicals goes through there. Looks like Wildcat is still fighting it out. Willy nilly's chosen one just went in the game. Zombies, at wow, some of the creatures on the field just have insane amount of attack. Neferetta, 24-33, 14-15, 12-22. For its summoner, so is that cat that heals? Or is it willy nilly that heals? So what I'm not sure how that. I think that card just heals the player who played the Heavenly Help, not the player who summoned the Abyss. Because it's summoner. It's tough wording. Oh, so it does heal cat, so it heals whoever's the creature. That's a very good skill. Especially in 44 power, just use that at the end. Judge Titus or something. Oh, something ridiculous like a Battle Abyss. Cat's almost at full life again. This is going to be interesting. No talking for now, much focusing. DB. Yeah, it's taken care of. Second. Christ, that Armageddon. Wow, 3 armas already, the first 11 turns. Ooh, looks like we win this one. It's 3 minutes left on the clock. I'm just focused on playing here.
And this is pretty much over here.
What's gonna happen first? Time run out. So it's a final. This is going to be a quick game. I'm going to get spiked out. That was a boo-boo. Well, that's it for us. Yep, that's get wrecked. Let's surrender now. Oh, at 200. Oh, it's that random scores. Looks like there are two fights left and there are two power. I'm gonna go get my chart. Oh, I don't wanna win. Oh, spike. Kid of Pettings versus Kid of Pettings. Shame. Oh, he got just absolutely wrecked. Please plug in your PC. Your battery is running low. I shall plug in my PC since my battery is running low.
pee, but I don't think I have time.
Yeah, you got 16 minutes, and even after the match is over, you got 32 minutes or something like that.
Even if all the matches are finished at the same time?
You get like a 2-minute intermission, something like that. Just run and go.
So, I'm getting tired now. Radicals and Cools and the Kittens are down here in the second. Chosen Ones and Imp with Tarsus. Those are going to be Final Four. As soon as these guys are done here, which could be another 15 minutes, most probably. This is looking like it's going to HP at the moment. There's no clear field advantage at the moment. Lilith just eating up their HP. It's not going to be fast enough. Yes, Capricorn. Going to do some damage. Oh, nice crit. Looks like the left side has the advantage, but that's only because it was their turn. It's going to go back and forth, I'm thinking. They don't like Lilith too much.
Sup, son?
Just doing my broadcast is, has Byron not been around lately?
2 days gone.
It's very unlike him.
I haven't heard back from after he went to his doctor's appointment.
And a nice Guardian Angel on Lilith, so it's going to continue to eat up the HPs.
So, taking your advice on making a spike team has really paid off this week.
Well, you racked us, that's for sure.
Hey, and the two people we faced before y'all ran straight anti-rush, and we smashed them too, so don't feel bad.
We didn't have time to switch decks, so it was way, way too... It was, we had like 12 seconds after the match was over, the previous match, and we just couldn't switch. I switched to my 1's deck versus my 2's deck, but that's all I had time for.
Yeah, where it had a little bit of anti in it.
Yeah, I had a little bit, but, you know, it wasn't a full anti deck.
Call of the week, man, didn't save us, but it opened it up for us in both of the anti people. We gotta have a spy in our guild, because every time we face elite and we have a spike team in the first round, they always know which team's running power and which team's running spike.
Yep, like clockwork. What's up, Santa? How's it going?
Well, it was going well until we got smashed.
That's usually us.
Go for it, dude. I'm sorry.
I just said, don't feel bad. That's usually us. It almost backfired on us again today, like B was saying. For sure there's a spy in our guild.
this match is 10 minutes left each.
It's been going so smooth. Like, all the setups. We even had Itachi log into Theo in the middle of a match the first round, and it still worked out fine.
Yeah, on a turn that, like, Itachi, Theo's cards were all ready to go. So we had to wait, like, two turns before we were able to log back into it.
Pop out of that channel for a little bit here, and there's the Judge Alexander with the heel. And out comes the Justice in the bottom lane. And again, there's a crap ton of petrified units on the field. 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this is just stalling down to HP advantage here. So there.
What happened? Were we talking too much for your show?
Yeah, a little bit too much. And then. No. I was saying something, now I forgot. Oh, that. It's just going to be a stall until one side wins by HP advantage. So 5. I was doing the HP calculations. 5, 11. Six. 24 HP advantage for Radicals on the left here. So much nonsense in the chat right now. Justice is pretty, especially when she's got that 527 going on. Oh, what is that? Is that an arcane altar? Yes, it is. Who? Saxe has an arcane? That is so random. It's all magic damage. That doesn't count as absorbing the sudden death damage, does it? I don't think so. Absorb all the magic. Remove Sanks and stuff, but all those pets are not going anywhere. You had 3 mages and a ranger versus 2 mages, a ranger and a priest. You're going to see a lot of petrifies. There comes Jerax to make the life difference even bigger. Damn, that's a cheap Arcane Altar. 365. Yeah, it's an Arcane Altar. Here it comes smashing in the bottom lane. And there goes that Arcane Altar. They don't like it too much. Now the left Radical is kind of pushing a bit, but it's so clogged up with all of the creatures just petrified on the field. Nonsense. Why don't you put its chamber there? Those two squares. Wouldn't that be better? Hit both of them. Oh, there goes Lori, fearing that Desperate Soul. Not great, as the Desperate Soul is about to die. Man, they petrify the card that's gonna unpetrify everything. Artemis is back to give everything counterattack.
Caden 5. Oracle 4.
Champion an 8. Felista an 8. Dragon Hunter in 6. Danica 5. And Saxay's 10 win for more Hero Bane damage. 3 minutes left here. And the Armageddon. Just wrecking everything on the field. That Capricorn dealing more damage to Biocapacity. Well, here comes another Artemis. Black Lotus with the heal. It's like Tanwyn's going down, but it's done enough work. Bye bye, Archangel. Gabriel. Larkus is back out again. Turn too late for the Armageddon. And 28 people watching this fight. Minute 40 to go, and it's just going to come down to hero HP, where the Radicals have the advantage, quite handedly. And Varkus didn't get too mad, only 5 attack from that Armageddon. another Archangel out. And Yumi just critting on everything. 1 HP holding up. Salmonetto has some nice cards. He's playing with the Zodiacs. Your drunks are on the other server. Oh, I'm stony. I make joke. You laugh. You think funny. No, no funny. Victory to Radicals. And let's see who won. Oh, the kittens won. What a surprise. So I'm gonna wish him luck. Good luck, guys.
Thanks.
Wishing Death Angels luck in the round, and I should probably hop out.
You stick around during our match, you can hear the madness between. It gets pretty crazy on what to do sometimes.
Yeah, I might do that. How much time's left?
It's right now.
Alright, I got Maya, Astral, two raids, True Shot, Deadly Blow.
I'll let them do the talking for this match. Vicious.
Yeah.
Turn three, I guess?
Yeah, turn three. We'll hit, Astral, Maya, triple raid, no, quadruple raid, and only use one military charge. Use B-Hump's Myth. And let's place everything in the back.
I just drew an Encourage also, unfortunately I won't draw.
I just drew the fifth raid. So, five raids.
No charge. Oh, I encourage will be ready. I also drew a repeating crossbow.
Nice. So, next, let's just use all five raids.
You don't want to save the raid because, like, for crossbowmen, they work. I have no removals, though.
I have one true shot.
Like, I've got a bunch of cards, but no removal.
I got true shot and deadly blow. Let's do it this way.
I have inspiration run also.
I don't need it.
Top row.
Both. We're gonna hit both row.
I have myth also.
Maya up front. X-Bow in behind them. It ain't gonna hit.
I tried to put, but it wouldn't go down.
Yeah, I ran out of time. I was trying to figure out myself.
This window is empty. Okay, well, I can draw Myth. We can't get rid of that thing, eh?
Yeah, maybe. I got two true shots.
Because I've got, I can get Myth, Encourage, two military, three military, two charges.
Yeah, I'm still sitting on three raids. Four raids. I'm sitting on four raids.
Okay, so what are we...
Dig Myth.
In the back?
Yeah. Oh, you have one? My bad. Use your charges.
I fucked that.
No, that was five.
No, it's because I put on the encourage on Myth, but it came back anyway.
Too many buffs.
Yeah, that's what I said. One, well, I put one buff too many on just Myth. The rest were fine.
I was looking at Maya. That's why I said there's five.
Yeah, no, I put the encourage on Myth, but I have Maya this turn and another charge if we want.
Of course I get blocked.
Okay, nothing this turn then, or do I put my Maya down because I have Myth now? Oh no, Maya won't hit him.
Yeah, Maya won't hit. Depending on what I draw, I can possibly have Godlike Myth.
Well, I have Swift Astral, two charges, and an Encourage next turn.
Okay. Yeah, I won't have Myth. I drew the other Myth.
I can also pull out I can't pull out Call of the Week. Swift Astral and Myth Maya is what I've got.
All right, and I can pull out Alice to kill Soren. I got a true shot for him.
Okay, I have inspiration, Ronald.
Alright, that's what I gotta use to get Eclipse's.
Do you have any raid?
Yeah, I got loads of raid.
Do I put Swift out?
No.
And now it's 4-on-2.
Okay, I've got Myth Maya next turn, double stab, pre-Myth.
I got Godlike, Myth, and one raid.
Do we want to keep Myth Maya down, or?
Yeah, because I got alternating Myths on.
I've got double stab. Do I bother? I save.
Save it.
So I have two double stabs next turn: pre-med, astral, and Maya. And I will have nothing on BM.
Alright, let's dig Maya. Alright, never mind.
Do you have a DB?
In two.
Yeah, I have one in three, fuck. Okay, I've got two double stabs, Swift Astral.
Alright, double stab Juliet twice. Stick. Nice.
I've got Maya and Swift Astral. You have your ring.
Oh, my bad. I got Myth. Godlike. Ah!
Sorry.
I'm not going to use raid. I just...
Okay, Well, I've got Myth Maya next turn, and now a raid, but... Oh, and I can pull the raid. No, I can't. I can pull a DB.
Where's your call?
Next turn. Yeah, I've got Call of the Week next turn, B, and I can pull his Myth also.
Alright, well, let's go down... Because I got DB to for set. And let's go down row 3.
Okay, so we gotta beef up our guys for...
You got Maya?
Yeah. Bottom?
Front. Alright.
I have Maya, Expo, Deadly Blow, and Raid next turn. And Myth. You have a Raid?
I do not. I have a Frenzy, which isn't going to do anything. Okay, so...
Frenzy can kill top.
Yeah, the wall. You have a Deadly Blow?
This turn, yeah.
Alright, Deadly Blow smash it.
Deadly Blow came.
Nice.
Dig Myth, is it yours or? Dig him.
Alright, I'm trying. I have no buffs.
No crit.
I got time to die for Kanum. And a deadly blow for Karma.
I've got I have Myth and Expo next turn. And Terra. Do you have any buffs or not?
No.